That sucked. Ladies and gentlemen, today we have a long boy to take a look at. We have the VP9 Long Slide Optics Ready Pistol. Now, I am a huge fan of H&K pistols. Several years ago when they came out with the VP9, the first time I picked it up, I was absolutely hooked and absolutely in love with the pistol. They have fantastic grips. The grips and the shape and the texture of them is very, very good. They have one of the best striker fired triggers on the market. I love the paddle style, European style magazine release. And then as far as aesthetics, I think they are just beautiful pistols. They're very, very aesthetically pleasing. I've had the VP9 for 5 or 6 years now, and I have at least 25,000 rounds on there, and those are legit 25,000 rounds, not Keyboard Commando 25,000 rounds. I also own the VP9 SK. For some reason, I actually shoot this pistol better than the VP9. I've never been able to figure out why. The only reason I don't carry it right now, it doesn't have a dot on there, and I will add a dot to it eventually. A couple years ago, H&K came out with the long slide version, and now they have the optics ready long slide version, which is what we are going to talk about today. Before I get started, let me quickly do my disclosure. Yes, I work in the firearms industry, but that will not affect this review in any way, shape, or form. These opinions are mine and mine only. Don't really have any connection to H&K. I post thousands of pictures over the years, and I don't think they've ever liked any of my pictures, but that's okay. I still love them. I have met the VP of sales several times at trade shows before, and we chit-chatted. No friendship or anything, I would say, but I have met him a few times, especially when they come out with new products. I always make my way over there and check out those new products. Let me also quickly thank my 3 channel sponsors, my badass Patreon supporters, and my friend Johnny. Now, Johnny is a local buddy of mine. This is his VP9 long slide that he let me borrow for the review, which was extremely kind of him, so I need to say thank you to Johnny. And when I give this VP9 back to him, he is also going to give me the Staccato XL for a review. If you can't tell by the model number, the VP9 SK is the subcompact version. It is roughly the same size as a Glock 26. The VP9 is a little bit larger, obviously. Size-wise, it is right in between a Glock 19 and a Glock 17. It's right smack in the middle of both of those. The VP9 long slide has the same size grip as the VP9, but a much longer slide, obviously the long slide version of it. As of right now, it's available in 2 different options, and they're both listed on HK's website as limited time opportunities, so this may change, but as of right now, you can buy just this completed slide barrel, recoil spring for MSRP of $4.99. Or you can buy a completed pistol. Those start at an MSRP of $8.99. Now that's just the MSRP. You should be able to find them for less than that. Originally, when H&K came out with the VP9, they held 15 rounds of 9mm. When they put out the Gen 2 version, they upped that 15 rounds to 17 rounds. However, with the long slide version, they give you 3 magazines that hold 20 rounds of 9mm thanks to this additional base plate. All H&K magazines are very, very high quality. They are metal magazines. They are made in Germany, but they are not cheap. There will be a link down in the comment section, pinned in the comment section, not in the description, comment section. If you want to get HK magazines or take a look at the pistol, you can click that link and it'll hopefully find you guys some good deals. These typically go for around $60 for the 20 round magazine, and then the 17 round magazine is typically going to cost you around $46. Now I am going to go out on a limb and say the VP9 has the best grip out of any polymer pistol I have ever felt today. Yes, the best grip ever. The shape, the ergonomics of it, the finger grooves line up perfectly for my hands, and the second I grabbed it, it just fit my hand perfectly. It does have two small cutouts at the bottom in case you need to rip a magazine. Another big part of why I love the grip so much is it's very modular. You can not only replace the back strap, but both side panels as well. You can take them out. All three have small, medium, and large, and you can customize and set up the grip to fit your hand perfectly. And that's one of the things I love about the VP9. The texture of the grip is okay. I personally like more aggressive grips, aggressive textures, and this one is mild, especially up here, this top area. I don't like this feel of slick polymer. So most of my grips, you'll see, have a set of talon grips on there. I like the feel of that talon grip, and these would if this was mine, I'd probably throw a set of talon grips on here as well. Now the magazine release, I'm also gonna go out on a limb and say the paddle magazine release is significantly better than the standard magazine release. Now, before you blow up on me in the comments, I know I am the minority when it comes to the paddle magazine release. At first, I wasn't a huge fan of it. It took me a little while to get used to it, but once I brought it to a few classes and did a whole bunch of magazine exchanges, I am significantly faster with the paddle magazine release compared to the standard magazine release. Once again, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say the VP9 has one of the best triggers out of any striker-fired polymer pistol. I know there's quite a few that are up there, maybe a little bit better, but this is definitely among the best striker-fired polymer trigger. The weight is decent. It's probably in that 5-pound range. And as you shoot it more, it definitely cleans up and gets lighter and more crisp. The trigger on my VP9 and the VP9 SK has been shot so much, they're very well broken in. But you have your normal little bit of take up, not too much. You have a very crisp, nice break, and you have a decent little reset. Overall, really helps you shoot this gun very, very accurately. Now your rail up front, very, very standard 1913 cutout. It has four cutouts, so you can add most lights, lasers, or doohickeys. Slide release, I love the slide release on the VP9 pistols, and there's a couple of reasons for it. One, it is ambi, so whether you're shooting lefty or righty, or you're shooting offhand, whatever, you'll be able to drop that slide release if you choose to use it as an actual release. I can very easily reach it and drop the slide release, which is something that's very, very important to me. I know it's not important to everyone. Even on the other side of the gun, if you're a lefty or shooting offhanded, it's very, very easy to drop that slide release. Now, the slide releases look different. They're not the same size and shape, which is unique. Most guns have the same on both sides, but regardless that they look different, they're both still very, very effective. Moving on up to the slide, you do have rear serrations and you have front relief cuts. Not only do the relief cuts look fantastic, they make the pistol look very, very aggressive, but they work really, really well as serrations. So if you choose to rack the pistol from the front, however you do it, they are very, very effective serration slash relief cuts. The finish on the slide is very, very durable, whatever HK wants to call it. It's like a nitrite type finish. If you look at this VP9, this has been in and out of the holster, I don't know, about a trillion times. And there is some wear on here, but not bad at all, considering it's a 5-year-old pistol that's probably been holstered a trillion times. The sights on the new H&Ks are great. The old ones were okay, but the new ones are significantly better. You have a good ledge for one-handed manipulations. The old ones were snag-proof sights, and you couldn't rack the rear slide off a belt or something if you ever needed to. The front sight has a very, very bright yellow circle, and then inside the front and the rear sight, you have three tritium vials. So if you're shooting at night, it'll be very, very easy to pick up these sights. Another unique thing that this pistol has, all the VP9s have, is these cocking tabs that stick out of the back of the pistol. They're just little pieces of plastic that stick out that help you get a better grip on the slide, especially if you have grip strength issues. Now the original VP9 were just little plastic tabs that stuck out that were flat. These now, they changed the design of them and they kind of angled or they kind of level off. I'll show you what I mean here. And they're much easier to grab and much smoother. The one thing I will tell you is these are just plastic. The old sights of the old VP9, again, were snag free and they didn't have that ledge to rack off of. So I used to use the caulking tabs to rack off of my belt, and I broke several of the caulking tabs. So do not use them for one-handed manipulation. Top of the slide, these are optics ready. All of the new VP9s are available, or the VP9 and the long slide are available in an optics ready system, which is fantastic. Because of that, I wish it came with suppressor height sights. Not the end of the world, but I think if something is optics ready, most people are gonna put an optic on it now, and it might as well come with those suppressor height sights. Anyway, the optic system overall is decent. I'm gonna call it good, not perfect. Does not come with any of the plates. H&K does offer 5 different plates for the most common RDS systems out there. They're all plastic plates, and that's why I say it's a decent system. I always prefer to mount directly to the slide, or if you get a metal plate at least, that's better than the plastic plates. The plastic plates can just warp and break, and a lot of things I've seen with the Glock MOS system gives me hesitation on some of these plastic plates. Anyway, the 5 plates you can get. Plate number 1 is for the MEPRO Light Sight, EOTech, and the Noblex. Plate number 2, which is gonna be the most common one, it works with all of your Trigicon RMRs, SROs, Holosuns, etc. Plate number 3 is gonna be for the Seymour sight. Number 4 will also be common, it's the Loophole Delta Point and the Sig Romeo Pro 1, 1 Pro, whatever it's called. And then plate number 5 works for your Burris Fastfire 2 and 3 and your Vortex Viper and Vortex Venom. Now, taking these pistols down are very, very easy. It is the same as the VP9. Of course, the first step is to lock the slide to the rear and be 110% sure that the gun is unloaded. Your takedown lever is on this side. Slide it down, bring the slide forward, and the slide comes right off of the frame. You do not need to pull the trigger. The guide rod is a captured, the recoil spring is captured on a steel guide rod. Words are hard sometimes. HK's barrels are fantastic. They are cold hammer forged. They are cannon grade steel, whatever that means. I just know they're very, very high quality and they are going to last forever. The Longboy here is a 5-inch barrel. The standard VP9 is around 4 inches. It has this bushing here on the end that HK says it helps lock up the barrel to the slide better, which is going to help with accuracy. I was shooting it out to 100 yards, no problem. Getting hits fairly easy at steel at 100 yards, but I've also done that with my VP9SK, so you know how much more it's accurate, I don't know. I don't do bench rest tests. I find them painfully boring. Now, comparing the dimensions of the long slide to the standard VP9, as you see, they are very, very similar. The biggest difference is obviously going to be the length. The long slide is about 3/4 of an inch longer than the standard VP9. Because of that, it is about 2 ounces heavier, and then your MSRP on the long slide is either 900 or 1,000, depending how many magazines you want to get. And the standard VP9 is MSRP of 720. Again, that's MSRP. You should be able to find them for less than that, but God knows here in 2020. Pros, I think the VP9 has the best grip and the best ergonomics out of any polymer pistol out there. I know that's very subjective, but I personally love the VP9 for that. I love the paddle magazine release. Again, I know I'm the minority, but once I took the time to get used to it, similar to red dots, once I dedicated the time to get used to it, I am significantly better with the red dot and the paddle magazine release than the standard iron sights or standard magazine release. The slide release on the VP9 series is great. Being able to reach the slide release with the thumb on my strong hand is very important to me, and the VP9 is in a good spot and it works very, very well. Finally, I'm very happy that they added optics ready system. I took them a little while, but the VP9 and the long slide is finally available in optics ready systems, which I was very, very pleased. Let me not forget the magazines. 3 20-round metal magazines is great. I think pretty much all guns should come with 3 magazines. As far as cons, I have a couple. I'd like to see suppressor height sights. Again, I don't know if everyone is gonna agree with me on this, but if you have an optics ready pistol or a threaded barrel, you might as well include the suppressor height sights, in my opinion. The grip, while the shape is perfect, the texture is not overly aggressive. Again, most people will probably prefer this. I like very, very aggressive grip, so I would like to see it a little bit more aggressive. As far as uses, this is obviously a competition gun. Most people who buy this gun are going to use it for competitions and going to the range and plinking and stuff like that. You could absolutely use it for home defense. It has a huge sight radius. They're very, very reliable. They're very, very durable. It has great magazine capacity. So this easily could be a bedside gun. If you are spicy like me, you could carry this. Make sure you have a good belt and a very good holster, but I have no problem carrying full-size guns appendix. For example, I carry my X5 Legion, which if you don't know, weighs almost twice the amount of this, with a light and a red dot. Appendix does not faze me in any way, shape, or form. As my kids would say, Dad, you are such a noob. Once again, my battery died in my camera. One day, I will remember to change the battery in my camera before I start a review. Anyway, last two things before you guys go. Let me thank my friend Johnny, who let me borrow this pistol for the review. It is very, very kind of him to do that. Second, if you are looking to pick up any of these magazines or the pistol themselves, again, check the link down in the pinned section of the comments. It's an affiliate link. I will get a very, very small kickback. You don't pay anything extra, and it helps keep this channel going. So thank you guys very, very much for watching. It is greatly, greatly appreciated. If you are looking to support the channel, the best way to do so is on Patreon. If you are not willing and able to donate a few dollars per month on Patreon, no big deal. Just keep the likes and the comments coming because they really, really help me out. Now, if you want to know what videos I have coming out next, please consider subscribing to the channel and enabling the bell notifications. This way, YouTube will hopefully let you know when I come out with a new video. If you want to know what videos I am working on right now in real time, consider following me on Instagram, Facebook, Parler, MeWe, Rumble, YouTube. I'm on every platform I can find. The links to most of them are down in the video description. I do have three really awesome channel sponsors that help out this channel significantly. First is Blackout Coffee Company for all of your caffeine and coffee needs. Dangerous But Good sells Christian and pro gun apparel. Third is USCCA for your concealed carry insurance. The links to all three are down in the video description. One more time, let me say thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time. Peace.